What is Dolby Vision, HDR, how does it work, and most crucially, how can you take advantage of the HDR format? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will explain what is Dolby Vision and what can it improve in HDR content. So without further ado, let's start with the video. If you are new to my channel, I would appreciate if you subscribe and view my other videos. So without further ado, let's begin. The most significant advantage of Dolby Vision HDR is the addition of dynamic metadata. So this metadata carries scene-by-scene instructions that a Dolby Vision capable displays can use to make sure it portrays the content as accurately as possible. Now let's assume Dolby Vision is built on the same core as HDR10, which makes it relatively straightforward for content producers to create Dolby Vision masters together. This means that the Dolby Vision enabled Ultra HD Blu-ray can also play back in HDR10 on TVs that only support that format. Now let's talk about how it delivers better picture. So initial experience of Dolby Vision in the UK was that it plays a Dolby Vision TVs, and in a head-to-head comparison, Dolby Vision images appeared to certain more tone definition in bright areas. So it really gives you a very good experience. And let's talk about how can you watch Dolby Vision. So with more and more 4K Blu-ray discs with Dolby Vision hitting the shelves, an increasing number of 4K Blu-ray players now come with Dolby Vision support as a standard, including top-end 5-star players. Also, it's a more complicated story when it comes to TVs, because not all manufacturers support Dolby Vision, and those that do don't implement Dolby Vision on all their models. So you will tell to find out all but the very budget end of their ranges. Well, Sony and LG have Dolby Vision on their lion's share of their TVs. Philips and Panasonic are usually compatible with both HDR10 Plus and Dolby Vision, but Samsung is HDR10 Plus only. Now let's talk about how you can watch Dolby Vision content and which brands don't support Dolby Vision. So right now, Samsung is the only brand that does not support Dolby Vision, while other brands are actually moving towards Dolby Vision. And while Dolby has gone out of its way to dismiss talk of any possible format war with HDR10, it mainly becomes that Dolby Vision content is already available and you can actually enjoy this content very much. So Dolby Vision is a proprietary dynamic HDR format developed by Dolby Labs. By adjusting their metadata, and the most important thing is what and how you can enjoy HDR content which is already available in many formats, and what will it give you when you are using Dolby Vision. So basically you need to know this, because it is a set of technologies developed by Dolby Laboratories for high dynamic range video. Now high dynamic range basically means any video which have high dynamic range, that is the brightest and the darkest scene in a single video. So this is very important, and you should know this, because high dynamic range is the most important format right now, and it gives you a lot of features, lot of interesting features and things. So you can see lot of enjoyable content, and it confers basically content creation, distribution and playback. And Dolby Vision includes dynamic metadata that are used to adjust the brightness, color and sharpness of each frame of the video to match the display color volume, that is the maximum and minimum brightness capability, and the color gamut. It allows for the creative intents to be preserved on all Dolby Vision compatible displays. It was introduced in 2014, making it the first available HDR format. Now latest Dolby Vision is Dolby Vision IQ, which is an update designed to optimize Dolby Vision content according to the ambient light. So it means the Dolby Vision content will be adjusted according to the light of the environment in which Dolby Vision content is playing. So if you are sitting in a dark room, Dolby Vision IQ will adjust itself to the dark circumstances, and while you are sitting in a bright room where there are a lot of lights, then Dolby Vision will accordingly adjust to the situation. Now Dolby Vision allows for a maximum resolution of 8K up to 12-bit color depth, maximum pre-brightness of 10,000 nits. However, according to the Dolby Vision white paper, as of 2018, professional reference monitors such as the Dolby Vision HDR reference monitor, these are currently limited to 4000 nits of peak brightness. But in future, we may be able to see Dolby Vision on a high dynamic range with merging multiple exposures. So technically speaking, it includes the PQ transfer function, a wide color gamut color space, in up to 8K resolution and for some profiles up to 12-bit. It can encode mastering display colorimetry information using static metadata and also provide dynamic metadata for each scene or frame. This dynamic metadata or dynamic HDR allows adjusting of brightness and contrast on the scene by scene or even frame by frame based as when required and adjusting many times during the video or movie. So these are the details of Dolby Vision. But for those people who are actually new to this technology and who don't know anything about it, let's see, you are watching standard definition image where you will see the standard dynamic range where there will be brightness and darkness in the scene, but the whole scene will be simple. But when you are using Dolby Vision or HDR10 content or any kind of high dynamic range content, the creators will set the range of each and every scene according to the requirement, and it will change according to the metadata that it sends to your television signal. So in layman terms, you will be able to enjoy deeper blacks, brighter rich whites, and a very vivid images which will immersive towards the scene. So in India, many televisions are actually supporting Dolby Vision. Many monitors are also supporting Dolby Vision. For example, LG OLED TVs, they all support Dolby Vision, and latest LG OLED TVs, that is C10 and C1, which is 2011 model, they already support Dolby Vision IQ, which is their latest Dolby Vision format. Also, many other television manufacturers like Xiaomi is about to launch their own OLED TV, which is rumored to be supporting Dolby Vision. Also, TCL, a Chinese TV manufacturing company, already supports Dolby Vision in their models. Also, Philips, Panasonic, Sony, and many brands are already supporting Dolby Vision. But Samsung, on the other hand, their own HDR 10 Plus, which I will explain in some other video. So this is all about Dolby Vision, which will give you richer experiences, how you can use Dolby Vision to create sensational movies. Now, if you are having any of these devices, then you can actually enjoy Dolby Vision without having to buy a separate Blu-ray player or any external media device. All you have to do is download the app which supports Dolby Vision natively. So the main requirement of supporting Dolby Vision is that your device must support Dolby Vision natively, and also there must be some compatibility towards the Dolby Vision source. So Netflix right now supports Dolby Vision on many of their titles, and they have thousands of titles available in which more than 100 titles natively supports Dolby Vision. So Netflix right now supports a lot of Dolby Vision content, and Apple TV Plus also supports Dolby Vision content. Now even Hotstar or Disney Plus are supporting Dolby Vision content. So there is no dearth of content right now. You can actually enjoy the content. All you have to do is just have a Dolby Vision enabled display device. Even MacBook Air M1 device supports Dolby Vision. MacBook Pro supports Dolby Vision. So no need to worry about. You can already watch movies and content according to Dolby Vision technique. And the HDR Dolby Vision is really nice, and you will be able to enjoy a lot of things. And in this video, I tried to explain what is Dolby Vision, how it is important, and what is revolutionized in the display technology. In my next video, we will talk about HDR 10 Plus, which is the rival of Dolby Vision developed by Samsung. So I suggest definitely go check out that video also. I will post the link in the description, and also view my other channel videos and share with your friends and family. I make these good contents every day. So every day you will be able to enjoy many channel and videos on my channel. Thanks for supporting. I'll be see you next time. Goodbye.